Hi everyone, Woniya from season 6 of Alone. And so many folks have been asking me to talk a little bit more about the Leatherman that I brought out and what some of the special modifications were to it. So you can probably see in most of my footage that when I am out there, I always, always have my Leatherman in its sheath on my belt. So there's an elastic piece on the side of the sheath, and I always had my ferro rod through there with a piece of pink paracord, which made it easy to see and keep track of. And I would wrap that paracord around, and then at the end of the paracord is a carbide striker. Now, I didn't actually use this to strike my ferro rod. I used it to sharpen my tools. But you can see my ferro rod technique in another video that I posted a couple weeks ago. So that was part of what was always on my belt. So 100%, I always knew where it was. Also, it's painted with glow-in-the-dark paint at the tip so that I could see it even in the dark. Not that I was starting fires in the dark, but just the peace of mind of being able to see in a moment's glance in the middle of the night exactly where your ferro rod and your other important tools was really key. So there are a lot of different Leathermen on the market, and I looked at a lot of different models, and the model that I decided was going to be the one for me was the Surge. And I decided that for a variety of reasons. The most important, and I know this might feel a little silly, but the most important issue for me was that it had a pair of scissors. So a lot of them have scissors, but they're usually one of the smaller tools that's tucked to the inside, and they're usually really thin and wussy looking scissors. I wanted the beefiest scissors I could get because I was planning on doing some crafting. I knew that I was wanting to work on some of the leather projects that I had brought out with me in half finished state, including my mukluks, which I had just talked about on my video about my boots that I wore out there. So those needed finishing. So I knew that having a good pair of scissors was going to be key in cutting out pieces and cutting thong, which is what we call sewing thread for buckskin sewing. So these were really, really good scissors. Another key thing is that up until the very last minute, I was planning on bringing snare wire, and I knew that I was going to need a tool for cutting my snare wire. So the Surge has nice wire cutters right there, which were going to be really key for my snaring. At the last minute, as I've talked about on a lot of these videos, I ended up changing my mind and not taking my snare wire. But I didn't rearrange all of my tool choices to not take this, because in my planning, this became so indispensable in so many ways. So those are the standard things that already come on the Surge: a nice pair of pliers with wire cutters and a nice pair of scissors. Also standard on the Surge is a blade. Now, I brought a knife as well because I am a craftsperson and I do a lot of animal processing, and having a really good knife that is going to be carbon steel so I can use it to get sparks off of if for some reason I lose my ferro rod, that seemed key. And the Leatherman knife is not enormously comfortable to hold long term for crafting and butchering and that kind of thing. Plus, the way this handle is, it doesn't make it very easy to use with a baton for felling trees or small poles or what have you. I mean, smaller trees, obviously, it's hard to take a big tree with a baton technique. But batoning is where you whack on the tool, and I didn't trust the strength of this mechanism for doing the really hard batoning work that I was potentially going to be doing. So, or for splitting, driving into a small piece for splitting for various craft projects. So the knife seemed really key, but having a backup knife really felt like a big deal, because a knife is a hugely important survival tool. Having a backup felt really good. And this ended up being really good for me because I was doing a lot of peeling of spruce poles. Mostly I was using the back of my saw that I had sharpened like a draw knife, but I would also do some work with this. And spruce pitch is very, very bitter, and it tastes really gross in your food. So it was really nice to have one knife that I used for animal processing, and then one knife that I could use for poles and peeling and other craft purposes that would get covered in pitch. And this thing was covered in pitch, and not have to get that off because I didn't have any way to clean it off easily for my animal processing. So that was really key. Another thing with the Leatherman Surge is that it has a blade exchanger. So it has a file in here that is both a diamond file on one side and a mill file on one side, which was going to be really key for keeping all of my tools sharp. So that was super important. And then the other beautiful thing about the blade exchanger is that it's not just a file, it is a removable file. So it has this mechanism so that you can actually take out the file, which means I can sharpen the Leatherman tools with the file that's included. If it wasn't in a blade exchanger, if it was just a fixed file like most of the tools are, I wouldn't be able to do that. So that felt really key. However, on the standard Surge, it comes with a saw blade as one of the things you can put into the blade exchanger instead of a standard full width saw. On a loan, we weren't allowed to bring any additional things to trade in to the blade exchanger, which meant I had to choose either the file or the saw, and I really wanted both because my long saw wasn't going to be practical for small craft applications. I really wanted that small saw. Plus, the saw is really, really nice surface for using on your ferro rod to get good sparks. So the other standard tool that comes in the Surge is a serrated knife. So you get a standard straight blade knife and a serrated knife. I didn't need a serrated knife. I don't really find serrated knives to be all that useful except for maybe cutting really ripe tomatoes or sometimes for some butchering, like for cutting steaks or something like that. Even so, I really prefer just a really good sharp carbon steel blade, straight blade. So serrated knives felt like a waste of a tool. So instead, my good friend, who is friends with the folks at Leatherman, got another blade that was a saw blade for me to put into my Leatherman. So this meant that I had a full width saw plus the file instead of either or. And all of them are full length, and the Surge is longer than a lot of the other models. So that means I have longer saw, knife, scissors, and file than I would have in other models. So that felt really key. So those things were huge. Now, some of the major modifications were some of these inside tools. So the Surge typically comes with a variety of different bits for different screwdrivers, a flathead, a Phillips, and then a miniature flathead and Phillips. And that didn't feel important to me. So of the standard tools that the Surge comes with, I have the wood awl. So this is a tool, and I think they talk about it for a leather awl, but to my mind, this is not a leather awl. So this would be good for boring into wood. So I went ahead and kept that standard tool that comes with the Surge. And then additionally, it comes with a flathead screwdriver, and I was considering having that just be a straight blade, give me an additional backup blade, but then I realized that my saw is one that has a screw on it, and especially with the way I was using my saw, kind of beating at the on it on the back to use it as a draw knife and to take the branches off of my poles, I knew that I was likely to need to be adjusting the tension. And as it turned out, that screw did loosen on me a lot through use. So it was really, really key to have a screwdriver out there, just a regular flathead screwdriver. I could also use this for prying. I did find some rusty tin cans, and I could poke holes into them using this and the awl, so that I could hang them from things or bind them onto things. I made a cool sand grabber with a tin can lashed onto a pole. So key for a lot of things. This is the can opener. Now, I knew that I wasn't likely to find cans of soup washed up on shore, so a can opener wasn't going to serve me out there. So my friend Rich carved this down so it's a crooked blade. So this is an incising knife, so I can get inside and carve out like mortise holes for different traps or building applications. Also really nice for carving. So I did make some nice utensils out there, a really nice spoon and a nice spatula, and I did some intricate carving on both of those, a grouse feather on my spoon and a trout on my spatula. So the incising blade was very, very nice for that. Not really survival necessary, but wood carving is a lovely thing to while away your time sitting around the fire in those many, many dark hours in the Arctic. So those are the tools on this side. This side is all non-standard from the typical Surge tools. So buckskin work and hide tanning are what I've based a lot of my adult career on. So they're definitely key to me, and I had a lot of plans to do some hide projects while I was out there, both from cutting apart the bottom of my parka or my quiver to make things as needed, and then also the mukluks for my for my boots, I knew needed to be finished in order to be functional. They were just in there as kind of raw pieces. And also, I was really hoping that I would be tanning some hides while I was out there. So a buckskin awl was key. Now, my friend Rich, we met when he came to do a class with me on buckskin sewing. So he knew what I like in a buckskin awl. So he's able to make this to my specifications and make a really nice buckskin awl. The other tools are more towards woodworking. And all of these tools, by the way, are made from the screwdriver bits. So one is a lovely chisel. So really, really nice for a lot of crafting and traps making applications to have a chisel here. And then the other one is a gouge. So this was super key for spoon carving and other craft work and careful shaping. Also could be used for traps. You can use this to go down and bore a hole and clean up other projects. So very, very useful to have out in that situation. So those are all of the tools on my Leatherman Surge. Again, it comes with pliers. Within the plier are wire cutters and then a straight blade, scissors, saw blade, and file with diamond and mill file. And then incising blade, screwdriver, wood boring awl, and chisel, leather awl, and gouge. So this was a fabulous thing to have out, super, super useful. I have some ideas about how this could be modified to be even more useful for bushcraft and wilderness living situations. So I recently had the opportunity to tour the Leatherman factory in Portland and talk to some of the folks there. And it was really amazing seeing where and how they're made and to learn that they're made with all US steel and they're still made in Portland, Oregon, where the company was originally founded. And also, I have a lot of other ideas that I think could be really applicable in a tool like this. So I'm hoping that there might be some possibility that a tool such as the one I'm holding right now, potentially with some even better features, could be available to the general public without a special relationship with Leatherman, which I was very lucky to have a friend who had. So big thanks to my friend Rich and to the people at Leatherman for supplying him with the parts and allowing him to use some of their tools in order to put this together for me. And if you are interested in the possibility of having a tool like this someday made, let the folks at Leatherman know. I have a lot of great ideas that I think could be awesome, and I think there's potentially a wonderful market for tools like this. So give me feedback on the YouTube channel and give Leatherman feedback about working with me to help create a tool like this that you too could have in your hands for wonderful wilderness living and bushcraft applications.